Transition Radio TV, brought to you by TheBestFormStore.com. They have everything you could possibly need for your cross-dressing and transgender needs. Visit their website at www.TheBestFormStore.com and tell them Transition Radio sent you.
I would like, if I may, to take you on a strange journey.
Once upon a time, there was a little girl.
The accident was over a year ago. A second woman has been elected president. A 12th planet has been named in the solar system. The last wild polar bear has died. I slept through it all. Was here for my waking. He called it a beginning. He said it was good. I think he may have thought that anything I did was good.
Welcome to Transition Radio. Your host, Mark Angelo Cummings.
Welcome to Transition Radio TV show, live from the land of enchantment, Silver City, New Mexico. Tonight's show is at a different time. We try to accommodate our guests, so it is tonight at 5 p.m. versus 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Well, Transition Radio wants to start announcing a GoFundMe of the month for those individuals who have contributed to our community and are in need of our help in return. This month is my good friend and amazing human being, Tom Moore. Please visit my website and click on the link that will take you directly to his GoFundMe page. Tom needs help with traveling and lodging expenses for his surgery. Well, tonight I have Paula J. Gonzalez. She identifies as a trans woman. I wanted to bring somebody on the show that would be civil enough to have a conversation regarding having Kathy Brennan on the show and to talk about all the backlash we've received due to this interview. She quotes, "Although I do not necessarily agree with some of the things Kathy says, there are some area of things she says that I do agree with. I think setting boundaries are okay and it should be respected. If they want to have event only for women without trans women, it's okay by me. Also, I agree with her when she says that lesbians have no interest in dating trans women. Totally agree with her, as lesbians do not like the male parts that some trans women have, and that's okay for lesbians, women to say that and set those boundaries and not want to date trans women. I also think there are more motives to transition than just the two Kathy presented during the interview. At the same time, as a trans woman, I'm not a man. Neither consider myself a man. That is basically attaching behaviors and attitudes to me or any trans woman based on the genitalia that may or may not be exhibited. Yes, I'm a trans woman, and yes, I was born male. I got no problems admitting that. I will never be fully female because I was born a male. It does not bother me when she says that trans women are not females. Yet, at this point, I do not think I'm not fully a male due to physical changes induced by hormones in my body. I do disagree when she says that we transition because of a fetish, as what she said in the opening video of the show. Paula was born in Puerto Rico, but moved to Albany in 2004 to pursue her PhD studies in environmental engineering at Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute, and because she needs to find a place where she felt comfortable transitioning. Along the way, she ended up getting involved in the community theater in 2006, did work as an actress and as a fight photographer, or actually choreographer. I'm also a local juggler, whip artist, and currently I work full-time in manufacturing. I have finished two associates, one in theater arts and one in business administration and accounting at Hudson Valley Community College. I've also been involved in local activism, pro-transgender rights. She spoke out in a lot of churches and in her local churches, although she is an atheist, and also has participated on local news articles talking about gender bill in New York City. Now, welcome to the show, the amazing Paula Gonzalez. Welcome.
Hi. How are you doing?
I'm doing great, thank you. I want to thank you for being on the show. That was a very impressive video. You look like you could really kick somebody's ass.
I still probably can, beat somebody's ass in the ring if I went to, you know. But that was a long time ago. I haven't gotten in the ring since 2008, basically. Although I will admit that I've been keeping myself training from time to time just to keep my skills up to date, you know. They are useful in my other in the other things that I do. So
yeah, it's amazing. You do juggling and you actually do whipping and all sorts of different really amazing, incredible things.
It's one of those things, you know, like It started as a way of like me finding things that I could do, you know, and then I just started playing like with things and, oh, I can do this. Okay, cool. Can I do something else, you know? And that's how it continued to until a lot of the things that I do today, you know.
Amazing. Well, again, I want to thank you for being on the show. I know that there's been a lot of controversy. I've had a lot of backlash and a lot of people critiquing the fact that I had Kathy on the show. And, you know, I'm a big believer that everyone's voice needs to be heard, not just one-sided. And I think that's what makes this world go round. And we cannot, you know, shut people off or shut people down or whatever it is that they're trying to do. So there seems to be a lot of animosity towards Kathy and towards anyone who will grant her a platform to speak, including me. Why do you think that is? Why must we try to shut people down like that?
I think the basic for that animosity comes from the fact that she has a different view about transgender people. But at the same time, she's not the only one who has a different view about transgender people. And that's why when you have somebody that is viewing transgender people in a different way than what the transgender people view themselves, you know, you're going to have a clash and a big conflict arising from those different views, you know.
But it's, you know, it's really a shame that people do that. I mean, we're being no different than the opposition. If we attack them, it's like an endless battle. You know, it's like, look, the planet's big enough for all of us. Let's agree to disagree. Let's be human here. Let's be compassionate for one another. I think communication is the key. I mean, I thought go ahead.
No, I agree with you. You know, like, just because somebody has a different view of transgender people, you know, don't necessarily mean that we have to go quickly into attacking that person. You know, I think we can have discussions where we can present those two ideas by being respectful, you know, of each other. You know, we don't have to go into like a point where it has to like being like throwing things at the person or attacking the person that is explaining their views. You know, everybody's going to have a different view, you know, I don't think everybody there will be some people that will agree and there will be people that will disagree, you know, that's just the way life is, but we shouldn't take it to a point that it's too personal, in my opinion.
Yeah, and that's what happens, you know, they take it very personal. They attack the individuals that will even allow somebody to have a voice, and it's like, what makes them any better than the person that they're attacking? I mean, it's, you know, I've been termed a TERF sympathizer, and they're putting me on the TERF watch list or something of that nature, all because I decided to have a show because I was curious. I was definitely curious to see, okay, well, why is this person being attacked? They're saying that she's creating animosity and hate crimes towards transgender females, and I don't believe that's so. I believe that what they're doing now, attacking everybody else, is actually creating more hatreds to our community. They're creating more of a spotlight of negativity towards our community. You know, everyone has the right to think what they want to think. Just let them be. Like I said, the planet's big enough for everyone. Let me ask you, do you feel that censoring people is dangerous due to treading on our freedom of speech?
Yeah, censoring people is dangerous, you know. But at the same time, one have to draw a line when censoring speech become like hatred that cause harm. But people are welcome to speak their mind. I mean, we can't censor people just because they have a different view than us, you know. It doesn't work that way, you know. People should be able to speak their mind, but at the same time, if they speak their mind, they should realize that there's going to be somebody else that will have a different opinion, and if they are not willing to accept that, then, you know, they shouldn't be speaking in the first place, you know. I know that for me, what my opinion that I will have, you know, I'm pretty sure that some other people may disagree with me on some things, and that's perfectly fine, you know. But at the same time, you know, I'm not going to try to go into attacking another person that may have a different opinion than me, because that doesn't help, you know. I think it's much better to have actual discussion where we can discuss some of the things that are going on, but in a civilized way where everybody can express what they think about things, you know, without having to censor each other, you know.
It only shows insecurity. If you're threatened, or anybody's threatened by my beliefs, and you have to attack me, it shows that you're afraid of the truth that I'm speaking, and you just want to do everything within your power to shut me up and shut me down. And that just, it's almost like proving, okay, you are insecure. What Kathy and what TERFs and what everybody else is saying, you think of it as true in your heart, and you're worried, so you don't want that being out there. If you're secure about yourself, anybody could say whatever they want about you, it shouldn't bother you to the least. And you shouldn't want to hurt people, because these people in the TERF, anti-TERF groups, want to hurt people. I mean, the things that they do is just as bad, if not worse. You know, like I said, I don't agree with many things that Kathy says, Kathy does, what the TERF does. I am not for violence of anybody. I don't think anybody has a right to hurt anyone. We're all here on this planet making our way and living our lives. So in no way am I a TERF lover. They've termed me a TERF lover, go kiss with Kathy. I mean, it's like immaturity. They're acting like high school children, you know, and that to me is just wrong. I mean, it's bizarre.
I wasn't going to say that, but you just said it, you know, like the way that some are acting is almost like children. Yeah, pretty much, you know, like, and the thing is that we're adults, you know, like, we should be able to be, to take things and be respectful of each other's ideas, you know. It's just the way that life is. Not everybody's going to ever agree with what we have to say, you know. It's just the way life works, you know. And if we cannot be civilized, we cannot have good discussions that leads to better things, you know, and to do more for our community, you know.
Maybe we should take all that negative energy and do something positive. All I ever hear these individuals do is attack people. You know, talk about love, educate, you know, do things to change these so-called TERFs' mind. You know, it's like, I welcome Kathy to the show. We had a very amicable interview. A lot of people have praised me that I was able to have a decent discussion without fighting with her, and she did the same with us. So I don't understand the whole commotion, the whole ordeal. It was there to educate. It was there to open hearts and minds. It was there to maybe create some conversation or open the gateways for some understanding between both groups. You know, by slinging mud at each other, we're not going to solve one single thing. Now, I could totally understand where Kathy's coming from in many ways. You know, biology versus psychology and feelings. This is what people see. You know, people aren't crazy. You know, they're like, they're used to certain things. And all of a sudden we come along, we say, oh, I'm this, I'm that. Well, people don't understand it, so we have to help them understand. How can we see our community, or what can we do for our community to try to sort this out and come to some sort of middle ground or understanding on this?
Just for start and for the record, you know, like, I didn't know who Kathy was until I saw the show that you heard, you know, like, but yeah, like, looking at some of her arguments that she make and the perspective of, like, biology versus, like, versus psychology and how we're feeling, you know, I think for our community, and I can only speak for myself, like, the way that I see things, you know, like, it's been aware of, like, of who we are, you know, as person, you know. I know that from the biological perspective, you know, like, I was born male, that nothing is going to change that fact, you know, that doesn't change, you know. So I'm aware of that. I may have a different, you know, background and different experiences that make me who I am today, you know. And also being open to understand the other side where she's coming from, which is from the side of, like, women that are born female, you know, they have different experiences that are totally different from the experiences that I may have experienced in my life, you know. But at the same time, I think we have to see if we can find areas where we overlap each other and try to work together in those areas that we overlap, you know, because there are certain things like violence, abuse, and harassment that happen to women that are female, and also that happen to transgender women, you know.
Right. We need to find our common grounds and not try to find our differences and fight. I mean, we're all fighting for the same thing: equality, love, understanding, acceptance. So to me, there's a bigger force, political force, that's creating all this ruckus and all this fight so that we can't unite as a group. And it's only destroying ourselves and each other and everybody else while we're at it. Now, do you think that the attitudes many demonstrate in our community is only creating more hatred and animosity towards us?
It's a possibility, you know, like, the thing is, like, I think sometimes if we tend to take things too personal, like, even myself, sometimes I may have taken some things that are personal, but, like, I've been learning, I'm trying to, like, grow as a person by not taking things too personal, you know, because nothing helps, my cause or the community if we take things too personal, you know. Yeah, there's people that are going to disagree, but we don't have to go quickly into ballistic mode against the other person and attack the other person, or even, like, the example that the one presented, you know, like, if you're out there and somebody misgendered you, don't go quickly into, like, the thing of, like, oh my gosh, you have to respect me, blah blah, or I'm going to sue you. No, you know, like, if somebody misgendered you out there in life, going through life, you know, it happens, you know, just, you know, go on with it, you know. Okay, it happened, maybe try to educate the person, or maybe ask for, oh, I'm sorry you misgender me, I prefer you to use this pronoun, you know. If they agreed, you know, they will treat you with respect, but don't go, like, attacking the person quickly, you know. That makes absolutely no sense, you know.
It makes it look like we're adolescents, you know, and it's like we're back in high school. I mean, today and yesterday, I've had this major interaction with somebody who I thought would be an affiliate, and I announced it last week, Genderqueer, or Queer World, actually. And they have a member in that particular network that's called Allison Wilbert, and she's part of the TVTP, which is Transgender Violence Something Pilot or something on another, but she's also part of the TERF list, sympathizing list, and really attacking people that may support the TERFs. And so they were going back and forth with the owner of this company, trying to make me look like I'm some sort of devil because I had Kathy on the show, and they were like just fighting over the fact that I shouldn't be allowed to be part of that group because I am a TERF lover and all this stuff. And it's like, you know, all they're doing is showing their true colors. You know, they're creating more problems. You know, they're dividing us. They're just basing their whole thing on fear and hatred. And that to me is just totally wrong. You know, so I renege on the fact that they are affiliates. I don't want nothing to do with that Queer World, and I don't recommend them at all, because as a business person, he can't sit there and take sides between, it's like little kids, you know, and it's like, you can't tell me who I'm going to have on the show. And they were giving me a list of things that they wanted me to do if they wanted to endorse my show, that I had to remove the interview and apologize. And I have nothing to apologize for. I mean, I've done nothing wrong. On the contrary, I'm trying to create awareness. But that is the kind of people that are dealing, or we're dealing with, that are controlling and just want to take over everything, which is sad.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. There is, I feel there's so much more to us than gender and the need to fight. I find trans individuals so incredibly talented. Just look at yourself. What do you say to this, you know?
I will say that, yeah, you know, like for me, being transgender is just a little bit, a tiny little bit of part of who I am, you know, but it doesn't define me fully, you know, because I'm very... As a person, I'm very complex. I have a lot of different ideas and a very different outlook of life, you know. And me being transgender is just a tiny bit of all the other things that I do, you know. Like, I took juggling because I felt interested in learning that, you know, and see how far I could go, you know. I never imagined that I could get to a point where I am at, you know. It's just the way that I am, you know. Like, there's more to life than just one particular thing, you know. And life has so many different things that we can go trying and discover about ourselves and about, like, different things, you know. That getting stuck only on one perspective, it doesn't do it for me, you know.
Yeah, there's a little video clip that I wanted Joe to play where we were having this interaction. I think you're juggling or something of that nature. There we go.
Oh, there it is. Oh,
yeah,
gosh.
Yeah, there it is. So,
some of the stuff that, oh, yeah, I got bored at night. Yeah.
I mean, I would hurt myself doing something like that. I could just see it falling right on my head.
Oh, my.
It takes a lot of coordination.
It's a lot of practice, honestly. A lot of people think it's like a talent or something like that, but actually, it's a lot of practice. Like, I basically pick up some of the juggling clubs and I start practicing, you know, and I put like a lot of hours just to learn how to do that, you know. And then I decided to get like some stuff that is heavy. I got carry over there, you know. I'm a little bit dramatic, you know.
How many times did you ever drop one of those things on
Oh my gosh, I don't keep count of that, you know, because like if I drop something, I just pick it up again and I just go at it and I try again, you know. That's the way that you can get to develop the skills, you know. If you just pick it up and you expect to do it like right from the beginning, no, that's not how it works, you know. You have to put the time, the effort, and also, you know, the attitude of like not giving up, you know. Things don't happen from one day to another, you know. I didn't learn to juggle from one day to another. It has taken me, and still, I still have to practice, you know. It's just the way it is, you know.
It requires a lot of coordination. I don't think everybody has that capability. If you don't have coordination, eye-hand coordination, all that stuff, I could just see it. I'd be one, because I have terrible depth perception, and I was born cross-eyed, so I could just see, doink, oh my God, boom in the head.
I still get hit sometimes, you know, like, I'm not going to deny that, you know, like, sometimes I just, like, I'm practicing, and then after a sudden I lose control, and then the things go flying in my apartment, which is very bad, especially because I got, like, so much stuff nearby. Even like my pet, so it's, oh my gosh, it's crazy.
I can imagine. But you see, all this talent and all this passion that we have, if we take that and do positive things with it, instead of reprimanding people, trying to get back at people and vengeance, I mean, when does it end? When does all this war actually end? I mean, somebody's got to be the bigger person and say, you know what, I forgive you. I'm sorry you feel the way that you do. I wish you well and move on. You know, the more we add fuel to that fire, the worse it's going to be. And it's just like, I'm sure Kathy did not start off being hateful toward trans individuals. I'm sure that, and I could see it because I've been attacked. And it's like, I'm this close to turning around and being hateful. And I try not to. I mean, I've had my interactions online where I've lost my cool because they make you lose your cool. They make you angry. You know, and it's like, that is not where I'm at. I'm in a loving place, but these individuals just like bring that out of you. So I kind of wonder, you know, was it that created the anger? And then like, oh yeah, you're going to say this about me? Watch, I'm going to do this to you. And it's like, where does it end? We need to say no more of this, you know? Mm-hmm. I believe that Kathy is only reacting, you know, which is what I said earlier. And she quotes that she has many trans friends, you know. What are your thoughts on this?
On that, I honestly, you know, like, it could be that she is reacting, but to be honest, you know, I'm not Kathy, so she's the only one that can probably answer that question, you know. But I do think that if we react violently to what she has to say, or like, or anybody has to say about us, you know, and we get angry and we get like violent, or we even give threats to the person, you know, I'm pretty sure that, you know, people are going to get scared and react in that way. It could be, you know, I don't know, you know, but giving threats or like getting angry, you know, or attacking people just because they have a different opinion than us, you know, doesn't do us any good and doesn't do anybody any good, you know, and it's from both sides, basically, you know, neither, people can disagree with what I say. People can disagree with my life. People can disagree with my opinion on things, you know, but like, you know what? It makes no point to go into that level of like insulting or making it personal. You know, we shouldn't be getting to that point, and nobody should be getting to that point just because of having a different opinion. You know, to me, it's like, if you have a different opinion, voice your opinion, say why you are disagreeing, but don't go to that point of attacking the person. You know, that doesn't help at all, and that doesn't, you know, makes you look in a bad way. You know, like, yeah, okay, somebody has a different opinion. All right, I disagree because of this and this, but I'm not going to, I will never go to insult or harass or, you know, give threats to their person just for having a different opinion than I do, you know?
They should take it in a different way. Try to do something positive. Try to change the minds of these individuals. You know, show them, hey, okay, I know you don't see me as such, but, you know, come in a place of love. Come with a place of compassion so that there's some sort of communication and some sort of union to take place. Instead, now it's just this constantly. And where does it end? I don't understand it. I don't understand. Yes, I know that violence is terrible. No one should be violent. Do what they're doing and saying what they're saying. And it's like, it needs to stop. It needs to stop. And we need to like put all our efforts into proper education, into things that really matter. Who cares about words? Who cares about, you know, they say, well, words kill. No, it's like saying gun kills. No, somebody pulls that trigger. A gun is not going to kill anybody unless somebody pulls that trigger. So we need to educate people.
Yeah, you know? That's the important thing, educating others, you know, because through this, like, and it's probably because of my background, you know, like some of the things that I heard during the interview that you had with Kathy, you know, I have heard some of those points before because of my culture, you know, and But at the same time, it's probably why I don't get offended too easily when I hear things like that, you know, because I even had to educate myself, and even I had to educate my family when I came out, you know. And getting to a point of like fighting and arguing didn't help, you know. I still have to like try to find a way where I could educate my family and my friends in Puerto Rico when I came out, because, you know, trying to make them, even if they don't change their view from quickly, but actually become more accepting and of me as a person, you know. It's and that's all, you know, like, and that's what we should be focusing, trying to find a way to educate as much as we can, you know. They can have a different opinion of who we are or why we go through this, you know, but we should be trying to educate them and you know, showing that we are also good people, you know. Going into attacks or ballistic, you know, it doesn't show our good side, you know. It only show like we're just angry at everybody, and that shouldn't be the case, you know.
And that's what the community has been showing as of late about everything, whether it's a Morgan Pierce show, with RuPaul, it's all out anger and hate. And, you know, I know that that's not what we're all about. And I know it's a very small group that's doing this, because I know a lot of trans individuals don't think this way. They're very well adjusted. They could handle certain things and talk about things as adults. It's just a little group, a little cell, but they're loud. And so everyone's afraid of them, and people need to stop being afraid of this individual, stand against them, and try to educate them and say, look, I know you're angry, I know you're upset, but being upset is not going to solve a single thing. I challenge these individuals, do something positive with this energy, find solutions. Attacking your attackers is not the solution. There's a show, you guys could call. The number has been placed in front of the screen. No one calls. All they have is keyboard warriors, you know, people that have all this courage behind the keyboard. But no one actually, you know, I've even challenged them. You want to have a Skype conversation so you could understand me, so we could talk. Instead, no, they'd rather smear my name. They'd rather make me look like I'm some sort of crazy madman. But that's what they do, you know, mm-hmm. and it's wrong. The number's right there. They could call. They're not calling. They didn't call during the Kathy Brennan interview, and they're not calling on this one. All they know how to do is call my sponsors, call the network, and, you know, try to sit there and create hurt. And mm-hmm. that's wrong.
Yep. Yep.
Totally wrong. So what advice do you think that, you know, as a trans individual, how do you think we could solve this problem? Because there's got to be a way that we could meet in the middle.
You know, like, there has to be a way. And I think it's like, as I mentioned earlier, I think the way is to like find common grounds of things that overlap in with both views, you know, like, and things that we can work together, you know. There are going to be things that neither side is going to agree. So, but there has to be something common that we cannot work, and trying to find those things, that's the key, you know, to be able to work together, you know, if we're ever going to work together. Although I, after doing a little bit of research, I don't know how that would be possible, you know. I think it would require a big shift in attitude from both sides of people that are involved, you know, from our community and also from the other side too, you know. But it's, I don't know, you know. That's the way that I see it. Maybe I'm very optimistic about like being able to find common grounds, but I don't know.
I think mediation is an important thing. We have to look at, okay, why do these individuals feel and think the way that they do? I mean, they're looking at biology. I mean, if we have an open mind and we could try to understand the factors involved in all this, okay, they don't see me as a man. I don't blame them. I was born a female. Am I going to get upset because of that? Now, they're saying that they've done a lot of terrible things. They've outed people and they've lost their jobs. That's not right, and I don't condone that. I don't condone any violence. But then we'd have to find out, why have they done this? Why would they end up wanting to hurt somebody just for the heck of it? Or was there something that created the whole scenario? Because, I mean, it's important to dissect things, and it's important to understand one another and find out what came first, the chicken or the egg? You know, this whole animosity, did they just all of a sudden wake up one morning and say, I'm going to be mean to trans people, and I'm going to out them, and I'm going to hurt them? I don't think it happened that way. I could be wrong, but we need to sit down and find out where it all started and how can we repair this? How can we change this?
I really don't know where it all started, you know, but like you said, you know, like I don't like and I disagree when they're out in some people, you know, our lives, the life of some transgender people, they are at risk, you know, we are misunderstood by not only one segment of society, but we are misunderstood by a lot of segments of society, you know, and the fact that sometimes outing a person can generate other problems besides the one that we're actually facing, that can be harmful, you know, and I think outing somebody, it's wrong, which, you know, like, they shouldn't be getting to that area, you know. They should be a little bit respectful of that, you know. But why they started doing that, I don't know. You know, like that's a big question that only they can answer, you know. But it's to me that thing of like outing people and all that stuff. I think it's almost like going to you know, you said it earlier, like going to a childhood level, you know. Oh, you said something that we disagree. We're going to put you in here, and we're going to you know, like it's really bad, you know. At the time, I'm already very open about myself, so like, you know, like I'm out myself, you know, but I don't like to tell that to people, to everybody that I meet on the street, you know, because that's something very personal, and also I don't know how people are going to react, and that could, outing people can put people in very difficult positions, you know. You will face not only discrimination in your employment, but also you could end up getting, like, you know, harassed or even attacked by people by just when they find out about you, you know, and that's something that it's that shouldn't be done, you know, just because of these problems that happen, you know.
It's definitely wrong. It's not something that anybody should be doing, but it's like, again, let's find out why. Let's make it stop. Let's come to some sort of agreement as adults. We're not back in high school. This is not the Jets against the Shark in West Side Story. You know, we need to, like, really act like adults, bring it to the table. Whoever's responsible, whoever the head turf, which I know it's not Kathy, is, and whoever, and I know the trans community doesn't have a head anybody because no two trans people could agree on anything, but we need to sit down, you know, and really work this out and stop the animosity. You know, I say to Allison, oh, she's going to put me on that whoa list of turf, whatever. It's like, what have I ever done to you? You know, I'm just a trans guy who's been advocating since 2004. I do my best to try to educate and help people. I'm not perfect. I'm far from perfect. I get upset, you're going to see the Cuban in me come out. But when I settle down, I come from a place of love. You know, mm-hmm. I've been attacked. My relationship went to heck because of all this pressure that we received from the trans from some of the trans community. And it's wrong. We need to stop this. Whoever started it, it doesn't matter, but we need to stop it. We need to focus on positive things in life. Stop beating up on one another emotionally, not just physically, but we're doing it emotionally. You're going to cause a lot of suicides yourself, and you're trying to blame everything on everybody else. Look within. Look within, and you know who I'm talking to. Would you have any final words or thoughts? And I'm sorry, because I get very passionate. I've had been dealing with this for...
Look, it's okay, you know, like back when I saw the show and I commented on the show that we're talking about, you know, like I saw some of the comments and honestly, like, you know, it's crazy and it's you can only take so much of that, you know, and I can't understand how you're feeling, honestly. So it is what I'm sorry you're dealing with a lot of like a lot of things going on, you know, like, I apologize for that, you know, it's one of those things that one can never expect, but, like, that's just plain wrong, you know, the way that some of the comments have been, you know, and I think that it has been a little bit unfair, you know.
Yeah, so. And then what they do is that they take what I say and they put it, but they don't put what they say to me, you know, when they share it. And they've, like, made me look like I'm some sort of monster. And it's like, I'm human, you know, I'm human and I get upset just like everybody else. And, you know, yep. This whole thing happened during my separation or my breakup with Jessica. So add that on top of this, I was just like pulling my hair as I have none, you know. And it's wrong. And, you know, we need to stop. You know, I'm begging all of you. I'm begging every single one of you that are responsible. TERF, trans, anti-TERF, anybody that's responsible for this. Take a deep breath. Stop. Find in your heart to forgive. Yes, they've done bad to us, but we're doing bad to them too. So let's just stop. Let's just take a deep breath here and try to start anew. Forgive and go into this, your heart from a place of love, and let's try to do it that way. No more children or child's play, you know? It's just, it's crazy.
Yep.
Anything else you wanted to say? Any final thoughts?
I think, you know, like, coming from a perspective, like, and only from a personal time, I think, like, we have to be more relaxed about things, you know, like, if our community is getting angry for, like, oh, because somebody said this or that, you know, like, it's never going to help us. We have to be more, you know, we have to do activism to show some of the things that we're facing and try to solve some of the problems that affect our community. But we never have to go to the point of, like, having to go insulting or making attacks to somebody else or another segment of people who may disagree with our views, you know. And there's so much stuff that we have to try to do better, you know. And I think it's probably trying to put more people in, making into positive things, you know, making us look more positive towards society. Because, like, the more that we can put ourselves into showing, like, oh, hey, we are individuals that are contributing good things into society, whether it's, like, at our jobs or on art or on other areas, you know, that will help change the perspective of people out there, you know, that have a negative view of transgender people, you know. And if we cannot find those things that are positive to talk about them and to show them, which can be talking in the first place, you know, not everything has to be negative, you know. Yeah, there are negative things. There are negative things that happen to us. There are negative things that we would like people not to say, but at the same time, that shouldn't be the whole focus of this, you know. We should try to find the good things and try to check out the good things, so that way it's better for us, I think, you know.
Exactly. That old saying, what you we resist persists. So we need to focus on good and not so much bad. As we continue to focus on the bad's going to continue to happen. We have to take responsibility at some point or another, not blame everybody else. I want to thank you so much, Paula, for being on the show, and appreciate you being, I know that you have to go to work and all that good stuff, so glad we were able to have you. And
it is what it is, you know, like, I just going through life trying to, you know, do my best to, like, first to survive and then also to try to change people's perception at work or, like, you know, in life, people that interact, you know. It has been a battle, because also I've been, like, close to the point of, like, being homeless and having a lot of struggles, you know, like moving far away to a place where you basically are on your own. It can be very, very tough, you know. And but at the same time, I always try to find ways of, like, where I can talk about, you know, about trans issues and because it's needed, you know. There are a lot of, like, problems that we face, and being on to the point of being discriminated in unemployment, when you're searching for jobs and all that stuff, it's very rough, you know. And it doesn't matter who you are. I think being unemployed doesn't discriminate whether you are, like, straight, gay, or lesbian, or transgender. You know, if you have no jobs and you're struggling in your job because of X or Y reason, it's going to be a hard time no matter what, you know, because of the economic system that we live in, you know. And trying to, you know, get to the point where I am, get out of where I am and get into something better. That's something that I'm trying to, like, focus right now, you know. And I know my life has been, like, very busy lately, but at the same time, you know, it's a balance, you know.
Yeah, definitely. Well, thank you once again. Well, we're going to take a quick break to announce another sponsor, Dr. Mariosia. We'll be right back with Ask a Trans Man, the transition video of the week, and my new Acoustic Cafe segment. So stay tuned. Little boy, you're a man. Little man, you're a king. He's a facial feminization surgeon in Jupiter, Florida. He did a fellowship in facial plastic and reconstructive surgery with one of the fathers of facial feminization surgery. He has also completed an extensive training in FFS for the past 6 years, working in close contact with his mentor.
Dr. Maderosyan performs surgeries in his office in a fully licensed operating room or in the local hospital with highly trained and reliable staff. Give him a call today at 561-624-0900. That's 561-624-0900. Dr. Maderosyan is highly qualified and understands our needs.
Fun, sassy, fabulous. Catch Fantastic every Wednesday, 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific on Gay Life Television.
Finding out you're HIV positive can be scary. It was for me. I was terrified. But then I realized that it's not the end for me, and it certainly isn't for you. My name is Robbie Aldred, and watch my show Positive Outlook, where we learn why it's no longer called surviving with HIV, but thriving with HIV.
And we're back. I got his email. It said, "Hello, Mark. My son, who was born female to male, actually was born female, identifies as FTM or female to male. It has taken me quite a long time to accept this and be at peace with it. Many do not realize how hard it is for a mother to let go of her daughter. I pray on this daily to find the strength and unconditional love in my heart to be the strength that he needs and support from me. My question to you is, how did your mother deal with this, and can my son find true love by being trans? I fear for his life and that he will have a lonely one. Yours truly, Samantha." Samantha, it can be a hard life, but it could also be a very rewarding life. It all depends how you look at it. Is the glass half empty or the glass half full? My mother had a very difficult time with this. I was her firstborn. Beautiful daughter, long curly hair, and all of a sudden she started seeing her daughter go bald and got all this facial hair. It was very difficult for her. It's almost like I killed her daughter. And for the longest time, she was very upset at me, resented. And I almost say that she almost hated me. But then after a while, she got to know Mark and got to understand me. And I'd say it took maybe a few years, 2 or 3 years, or maybe a little bit longer, when she finally embraced me and learned who I was and actually accepts me as her son. This happens to a lot of trans individuals and their parents. You know, recently Jessica's mom has accepted her. I read something on her wall, and, you know, I always told her, have patience. Your mother will come around. And she did, and they all do. It's just patience, loving, understanding, and compassion. We have to have that compassion. As far as for your son being alone, there's always someone out there. And as long as he's loving and supportive to that person he's with, he will find that special soul in his life. In the meantime, he has you, and that's what he needs, your love and understanding. And that's what we all, transgender, gay, lesbian, straight, we all just need love, and that's what we're here to do on this earth, is love one another and respect one another. So thank you, Samantha, for your email. I'll just knock my earpiece off. I hate these things. Anyway, the Transform the Norm contest starts today. Send your entry to transitionradioshow@gmail.com. I want to see your before and after pictures, shape-wise, not transgender-wise. The contest contestant will show the most impressive body transformation without professional help, of course. This has got to be all on your own. You will win 1 month free of online consultation and email with me, one of my CD Enslave, and a cash prize of $25. The contest starts today and it will end October 30th. I will pick three finalists and our viewers will select the winner. To enter again, please send an email to transitionradioshow@gmail.com with your name, your weight, your age, your before picture, and tell me what is the reason you wish to get in shape. 1 week before the contest ends, send me your after pictures side by side so that I could see the transformation and as well as telling me why and what you did to achieve this goal. On the 30th of October, we'll take a vote and chat, or people could call in or we'll chat. We'll figure out a way to announce the winner. Picture format should be front, side, and back view, JPEG, high resolution. It's time for the change we feel about ourselves. Self-love is an important tool to our spiritual growth as well as well-being. Let's transform the norm. Hocus pocus. Now you see me, now you don't. I'm a master of disguises, shape-shifting through the night. Many may never understand me. I don't even know myself. But I'm here on a journey to enlighten others as well as self. Let us not take life too seriously, for it's only a ride. Love each other dearly and live your life with pride. And now for the transition video of the week with Adam Beatty.
Welcome to the planet. Welcome to existence. Everyone's here, everyone's here. Everybody's watching you now. Everybody waits for you now. What happens next? What happens next? I dare you.
Send me your transition video to transitionradioshow@gmail.com. I want to thank my guests. I want to thank my sponsor, my advertisers, Joe. I also want to thank David and William on Gay Life Television. Thank you all for viewing and watching. Those of you that are creating all this ruckus, I plead to you, please stop. Both sides need to stop and realize that we're all just trying to live our lives and be happy. That's pretty much it. The song I'm going to play was a song written by myself, music by Jessica and myself as well, the group Transcend. It's called Forgotten. And this is a song that's, this could happen to anyone of us. We could lose our job. We could be in the streets, you know. It's important to think and be grateful and live in the now. So thank you. I love you guys, but remember to love yourselves too. Hello, said the man on the road. What's your story? What's your name? As I look at his face and saw the wrinkles that he made, we'll live our lives with hidden pain and forgotten. It's all a game. I'm wearing browns, getting tans, driving cars won't get us far. Wondering where we'd be if our jobs were taken away. Do you know where you'd go if your world fell apart? We'll live our lives with hidden pain and forgotten. It's all a game. Wearing browns, getting towns, driving cars won't get you far. That could be you, or that could be me. So you see that man on the road? He had a tent once and a car of his own, and now his life took a turn. But he's happier now than he was before. With all your goods and all your toys, you're unhappy and a prisoner of this world. We'll live our lives with hidden pain and forgotten. It's all a game. Wearing brands, getting towns, driving cars won't get you far. Or that could be me. Couldn't see that man on the streets without shoes or food to eat. That could be you. Oh, that could be me. Oh, baby. That man on the streets without shoes or food to eat. You won't be. That could be you, oh, that could be you, oh, me.